Welcome to This Week in Interface. As always, I'm your host, Ralph Cunningham. With me in studio today is Jeff Jones, Senior Director of Instructors and All Things Educational, right?
Yeah, that's close enough.
What we're looking at this week is what we have running. As far as remotes go, we'll take a look at those in just a moment, but we've got four classes, all four of them, this week running. The other things we have running besides those, we've got a 10776 with Peter Avila. What is that exactly?
Oh, that's a SQL Server 2012 developer class, basically. It's talking about implementation of databases, how to create tables, how to create various objects, stored procedures. They also get in things like full text indexes and a lot of kind of advanced topics on the developer side. So if you're interested in doing any type of SQL Server development, that is the class to help you see the whole picture of SQL Server.
Great. And what would you need to know to take that class?
Well, you need to know at least transact SQL. You got to feel comfortable writing a SQL statement, making sure you can pull the data out of it, out of a SQL environment. But that's pretty much it. From there, it's people that just want to be developing new databases.
Great. We also have, it looks like, an A-plus CompTIA certification 801 support class with Steve Fulmer.
Yeah, that's basically for people that are just getting into IT, a lot of new people that are new to IT that want to learn hardware and software environments for PC environments and understand the hardware, the operating systems that are going on. And Steve's taken the basic course from CompTIA and extended it and kind of made it special. So for those people who want to learn that kind of stuff, that's the class for them.
So this isn't really a stock CompTIA class, it's something that we've doctored up a little
bit? Yeah, we doctored up. We kind of tweak it up based on what they give us, and we always like to do that interface, and this is one of the classes we've done that with.
Good, great. Well, it looks like we've got four classes running. Let's try and pop into one that looks like they're actually doing something. It looks like Dan Wallin. Let's see if we can get some sound here. There we go. He's doing an introductory, well, not really introductory, a C-sharp programming class. It's not an introductory programming class, though.
It's not introductory. It's talking about C-sharp as programming. It's for people that are new to C-sharp and want to learn that as a programming environment, have some programming skills coming in, but want to understand C-sharp. And he's an awesome instructor.
How much programming background would you say you'd need to take this class?
A little bit. You've done maybe some coding in other languages, VB, and a lot of people come from maybe a VB environment that want to learn C-sharp. This would be a great one to get into, or any other type of programming environment. But he gets into some of the basics and steps you through it really well.
So I don't know what this is. Can you, what is this mess of stuff?
Static void main, that's a major, that's a, the basics of a program inside of C-sharp. He's basically building a little console application showing how to define some objects, how to write lines out to the user. We've just started the class up, so they're in the very basic parts of it.
So in layman's terms, everything you see on the internet kind of starts as something that looks like that?
Maybe? Yeah, basically that's code, and that's what we're all about. You gotta learn how to write code and to make computers do what you want it to do and the internet to make it hop.
Okay. And it had a full screen there on that one. Okay, let's see who else we got. We had Dan. We've also got, looks like Jason doing a PowerShell class.
Yeah. Where is he? He's not out there. It looks like they must be in lab.
That's half the fun of trying to look at a live class. You never know what you're going to see when you peek in.
So the cool thing about Jason, even though you can't see him, he was actually doing a video with Microsoft with Jeffrey Snover, who's the inventor of PowerShell. He was involved in a video that was broadcast last week, and he's here at Interface teaching this week.
Wow, so we have some heavy hitters.
He's a heavy hitter. Instructors. Yeah, heavy hitter.
Great. We also have, in this corner, Don Jones doing SCCM class, another heavy hitter.
Yeah, he knows more than PowerShell, and he also teaches SCCM for configuration management, and it looks like they must be on break or something, getting ready to get into another module. I hear some voice in the background there. Maybe he's talking off camera there. It looks like he's in the corner. He hasn't stepped on the pad.
Hasn't moved around. Let's see, we got any movement here? Again, we've got a SharePoint class. If you have never experienced Spike Xavier, you are indeed missing out. yeah, Spike's an extremely dynamic instructor for us. What kinds of things does he do?
Well, he's fun. He just has a good time teaching. He loves to teach. He loves students. And he loves SharePoint. And that's his specialty. That's all he really focuses in on. He does development stuff, so he brings a developer's perspective to it. This is the SharePoint Designer class, which really talks about how to enhance your SharePoint environment. It looks like they're on a lab right now, so they're sitting there doing their thing, kind of getting their hands-on experience between the lectures. So that's what Spike does. He's an awesome instructor. Everybody has a great time with him.
Great. Thanks, Jeff. We also want to talk about, just for a minute or two here, what's new in our video training library. We've got some new classes, early release Windows Server 2012 Advanced Configuration. What is that?
Well, you know, 2012 is a large product. It's a large operating system, and there's a number of more advanced features that people need to be able to configure, branch cache, getting into some of the other things in their child domains. Looks like global catalog servers. I mean, there's a lot of things that as you build a large enterprise infrastructure, you need to understand about the Windows Server 2012 environment, and that's what these videos are focusing in on.
Great, and Rick Trader looks like is the instructor for that.
Yeah, Rick is our 2012 instructor. He's been doing Windows Server instruction for a long time.
And I guess we've also got some new ITIL classes in the video library.
Yeah, we're starting to build out the ITIL library portion, and obviously ITIL is a big area for people that are involved in building out infrastructure from a management standpoint and process standpoint.
Mark Thomas.
And Mark Thomas is awesome. He been doing it for a long time, knows it inside out and backwards, and he's fun. He brings a lot of real world experience to it, and he's a great instructor.
Great, and it looks like also I've been told we have some Drillbits on Windows 8.
Drillbits. Yeah, basically Steve says there's lots of little things that people want to know about about Windows 8, and these are little kind of short videos that focus in on a particular feature or function that people want to understand, and he likes to do that. He kind of gets into the studio here and just kind of works on these little videos, and they're usually focused around some specific maybe troubleshooting technique that he's found. So and a lot of these get driven by questions that people ask in class, and that's kind of a great way for us to get a source of information. Students have a question about something that comes up over and over, we can just come into the into our studio and build a little video and make that available in our library.
Great, thank you very much. Well, guys, that's it. That's what's new at Interface this week. We will see you next week. Again, thank you to Jeff Jones for coming in and helping
out. Thank you. It was fun.